This video is on the topic of features of gas exchange surfaces. Let's start with thinking about what a gas exchange surface is. These are very important structures within organisms, as this is where oxygen enters the blood and is exchanged with carbon dioxide. The structure of a gas exchange surface will vary depending on the size of the organism, where they live, and the organism's energy requirements. All gas exchange surfaces have some features in common. These include a large surface area, thin walls, good ventilation, and good blood supply. It is important to remember that gases are dissolved in an aqueous solution before they can diffuse and are exchanged. That is why all gas exchange surfaces are moist. Let's look at these features in a little more detail. A large surface area means there's lots of surface available for diffusion of gases to occur. We often talk about an exchange surface as having a large surface area to volume ratio. All this means is that whilst the surface area is large, the space, or volume, the surface fits into is small in comparison. A great example of this is the alveoli in the lungs. If we spread and flattened out all the alveoli in your lungs, they would cover the surface of half a tennis court. A huge surface area that manages to fit into your lungs inside your chest, a small volume. Most gas exchange surfaces have walls that are only one cell thick. So there is a really short distance for gases to diffuse over. The alveoli within the lungs are adapted for this feature. The walls are only one cell thick, so it is really easy for oxygen and carbon dioxide to exchange here. The same goes for the capillaries that surround the alveoli. Their walls are only one cell thick, again creating a really short pathway for the diffusion of carbon dioxide and oxygen. Good ventilation means that there's plenty of airflow around the gas exchange surface. In the lungs, we constantly breathe in and out, meaning that we replenish the air inside each alveolus. This means that there is always a high concentration of oxygen inside the alveoli, ready to be diffused into the blood where it is at low concentration. When we breathe out, we remove the carbon dioxide from the alveoli, meaning that it is always low inside the alveoli, so more can be diffused from the blood where it is at a high concentration. This is called a concentration gradient, and it is vital for diffusion to occur, moving substances from an area of high concentration to an area of low concentration. Along with good ventilation, we also need a good blood supply. This is to ensure that blood keeps moving and therefore takes away or delivers the gases required. Again, this helps maintain the concentration gradients of oxygen and carbon dioxide. You can see in the image that the alveoli are covered in a network of capillaries to ensure that there is a really good blood supply to each alveolus, creating a steep concentration gradient. It is worth remembering that deoxygenated blood is brought to the lungs with a high concentration of carbon dioxide, and oxygenated blood is taken from the lungs with a high concentration of oxygen. Here we have an exam-style question asking you to explain how the lungs are adapted for efficient gas exchange. This question is worth 4 marks, so we need to address at least 4 different points in our answer. You do not need to write in continuous prose here, and bullet points are a perfectly suitable way to structure your answer. Let's think about what we need to include. Start with the main gas exchange surface of the lungs, the alveoli. We have many alveoli in the lungs. We need to explain this. Why is it important? Many alveoli give the lungs a large surface area. Notice the use of the word so here to help with your explanation, which keeps it simple. Next, let's zoom in on the alveoli. These have walls that are one cell thick. Let's not forget our explanation. So this gives a short diffusion distance for the gases to diffuse over. You could also name oxygen and carbon dioxide here. You would get the same marking point if you describe the capillary wall instead of the alveoli. We can now write about good ventilation as a third marking point. Let's explain this. Good ventilation maintains a diffusion concentration gradient. Finally, we can mention the good blood supply for our fourth marking point. To explain this, we need to again write that a good blood supply maintains a diffusion concentration gradient. So here we have a nice, clear, logical answer that clearly explains each adaptation. In summary, gas exchange surfaces are where gases such as oxygen and carbon dioxide are exchanged with one another. A good example in humans is the alveoli. All gas exchange surfaces have some features in common. They are a large surface area, thin walls, good ventilation, and good blood supply. These features mean that gas exchange surfaces are really well adapted to carry out diffusion of the gases being exchanged. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.